Hello guys, KP Shamino here, with another guide, and this time it's a guide for this fish. You can see it on my screen. It's the American shad. The main problem that I had with this fish was that I didn't know what kind of fish it was. So, as always, I went to Wikipedia to check it, and it seems that this fish lives in the Atlantic Ocean and comes to freshwater rivers or lakes to spawn. So that means I'm here at the moment in Michigan. So let's keep this fish. There is the Atlantic Ocean, and they come all the way through the channel to the lake in Michigan. So this is a very good position because this is like a gate that they all come to here. Then the next problem that I had, what is this fish eating? And yeah, Wikipedia, once again, it says that he feeds on plankton, shrimps, fish eggs, and sometimes he eat a small fish, but small fish are only a minor item in their general diet. So that was another problem, because if you go with the lure on a fish, a lure is most of the time a presentation of like a fish, a small fish. So I tried the lure, I tried the bobber, and with the bobber it was like 100,000 times easier to catch this fish. So shrimps, a bobber, it's perfect setup. If you want to go with a lure, it works too, but it's a lot harder to get the American shad with a lure, because yeah, it's not part of their diet. It's only a small part of their diet. So the best is to go with shrimps. I went with fish eggs too, but it was not the same as with the shrimp. Okay, so let's have a look where you need to cast. So I already said they come from the Atlantic, they go all the way. So the channel is perfect. You can throw practical everywhere where you want. It doesn't matter a lot. But I always throw over here. So you just throw in like this. So with the shrimps, and you just need to wait. Let the bobber go all the way with the flow of the water. And after on some time, you will have some bites. And most of the time, that's good about the shrimps too, is that it's most of the time always the American shad. So if you go with the lure, or you go spoon, or you go with the shad, you get a lot of smallmouth bass. You got the white bass. You will see it when I go to my net. So here you see it. That's how you need to do it after this movie, of course. Two small movies as always, with my catch, with the lure, and with the bobber. But with the bobber, it's a lot easier. If you guys, of course, like a little bit of a challenge, you can go with the lure. It doesn't matter. It's what you guys want to do, and with what you have the most fun. So just go with it. Okay, I don't have a bite. Let's reel back in. So that's how you need to do it. You can throw a little bit to the right, a little bit to there. It doesn't matter a lot. They are all sitting here. They come all from the Atlantic, and that's how you need to do it. Okay, my setup. I'm going to show you guys two setups. One for the bobber, of course, and one for the lure fishing. So first of all, I'm going to show you guys my bobber setup. Yesterday was the St. Patrick's Day patch, and I'm going with Phoenix 350. Okay, this is 60 gold. You don't need to go with a rod that heavy. The fish is only 3 to 4 kilograms big, and that's for the trophy. So you can go a lot slower, or a lot lighter, sorry. I'm going with the Hornet Swarm 6000. Once again, way too heavy for this, a mono 0.35. So if you can make a setup that can handle 4 kilograms, go with it. I'm going with a depth of 60, because once again on Wikipedia they said if it is very hot they feed at the surface, so you don't need to go that low or that deep, sorry. So 60 centimeters is enough. I didn't see a lot of trouble. I'm going with the 2-0 hook, 3-0 hook work 2, 1-0 hook work 2 with the chubby bobber. You can go with the water bobber too, of course. It doesn't matter a lot, the bobber, if it is not going under with the weight of the bait, it works, and that's what you need to have to catch a fish. Then I'm going with the shrimps. Shrimps are good for this fish, so go with the shrimps. I cannot say more about it. Just get a shrimp on, throw it in, and you will catch a lot of those fish. Okay, that's the setup for the bobber fishing. Now I'm going to show you guys a setup with for the lure fishing. So the main problem at the moment is that it's not a very big fish, and You don't need to make a lot of distance, but I prepared a setup that is perfect for it. So you see here, I'm going with the Jigwinner 2400. Yes, it's very low level rod, but you don't need more than this to catch a fish, because if you see here, the lure weight is 5 to 18 g. That's more than enough. You don't need to go with like very heavy tackles on this fish. The Prima 3500 works really good, max drag 5 kilograms, and the Bred 0.2. That's around 4.1, 4.5 kilograms of test that it can take. I'm going with the Nano Spoon 4G, one hook. It works. The Shad 9G, 1-0 hook works too, 2-0 hook works too. It doesn't matter a lot. The Casting Spoon 1-0 works, the Casting Spoon 14G 2-0 works. But the main problem, what I already said to you guys, is it's not part of his diet. It's not. Sometimes he eats fish, but not a lot. So you are not going to get a lot of fish with the lure. And I will show you guys right away in my net. So let's go to the net. And here you already see it. So I went with the Nanospoon 6G10. I had an American shad, it's possible. But if you check now all the other crap you get with it, smallmouth bass, white bass, so the amount of American shad is very low compared to the other fish that you are going to catch. Then I went with the Nanospoon 4G, and by the way, I like those Nanospoons. They look cool. It works too. Like I said, the shad 10 centimeter on a very small jig head works too. I tried the crankbait, I didn't have luck. You guys can see it here. The white bass likes to get the crankbait a lot, so here you see it. But you guys can already see it. I went to shrimps. In 2 minutes, I had two fish right away, two times American shad, and I didn't get anything else. So go with the bobber. That's the best to get this fish. I cannot say more than this. You guys got the setup, you got the position. It's a fish, yeah, you can fish for it. He gives 14 currency, 14 experience. I can say it's a fun fish, but it's not really a fun fish. He's a small fish, he's sitting here, you can catch him, and that's all. Simple. So yeah, that was my guide, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope that you enjoyed the guide. If you like it, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe please. And see you guys the next movie, I think. By the way, for the guys that see this movie after St. Patrick's Day, it's not a bug that the water is green. So if you guys see the tutorial and you say, oh, this water is not green, the tutorial isn't working anymore, the water has nothing to do with the tutorial. It's just for an event. Okay, guys. See you guys later. I'm not going to make it that long, because you probably have all a hangover. Bye bye.